Hi, everybody. It's Pastor Jeff from the Movement Church in San Marcos, and I hope that this week's devotional finds you in a good place, a good space, and full of grace. I mean, look at me. I'm rhyming a little bit. I want to go over some revelation, just a couple of points that I pulled out from the Word of the Lord or Sunday's message with Pastor Pat, and it was on the weapon of repentance. Now, repentance in my life has really been a stepping stone, if you will, where I was able to turn from what I was doing and turn towards God. And that's what repentance is. It means changing one's mind in the way you're going and turning your heart towards God. When you turn towards the one that's called you and focus on him, you make him your priority, you can get through anything. And all of us are going through something, whether we're going through it in our marriage, if we're going through something with our children, I would challenge you to start at repentance. Repent for the things you don't know or don't understand. It keeps your heart right. And the Bible says to keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it flows the issues of life. So the first point I want to go over is what Mary was doing. Pastor Pat said that Mary was looking into the tomb. Sometimes we keep looking at dead things. We need to stop what we're doing. We need to stop looking at the past, looking at the mistake, and it magnifies every time. Because Mary was looking for in the dead part where Jesus was. Jesus wasn't there. He had gone up to the Father, but she was looking for him where she thought he was. She was hungry for him, but he was not there. She was in the wrong place. Have you ever been looking for freedom from God, but have been in the wrong place? And it starts with not looking at the dead things. The second thing I got out of the message is remember when he calls your name. Jesus called Mary by name. He knew her. He knew of her. He knew her past. He knew her present. And I got a funny feeling that he knew her future too. But he knew her name in the most critical time where her heart was hungry for him. And she was able to hear him. See, we need to be able to position ourselves away from the dead things, away from things through repentance, so we can get a clear picture and a clear voice of the Father that calls you by name. The third and final thing is Jesus is a personal God. He's not far away. He's not a long way off. He was personal to her. He was in the tomb with her. So God is not afraid of your dark places, and God is not afraid of the tombs that we have in our lives. As long as a spirit of repentance is there, you will hear the voice of God on a regular basis. It doesn't matter how many times you've fallen. If you repent and turn every time, God's grace will lift you up. He shall do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask or think. So I want to encourage you this week to go over that word and repent over the things you don't understand. Turn from the things, change your thinking so God can pour out fresh grace and fresh mercy to you. I want to bless you and your family. I hope you guys are doing well, and I want to release a blessing over you. Stay blessed until we see you again.